IVM.
Hi guys, just like on this show, young fun people sit and talk about what they like and don't like in dating and people. Similarly, the IVM Network has another show where fun young people sit and tell you about their likes and dislikes in pop culture. The show is called Geek Fruit and it's hosted by geeks Tejas, Jishnu and Dinkar. They talk about science fiction, the latest movies that have come out, the latest TV shows that they have liked. You should definitely check out that show. New episodes are out every Monday and Thursday, so do check out Geek Fruit.
Dating is garbage, I'm not sure why people do it.
Hey guys, you're listening to Dating is Garbage. I'm Surbhi and in the studio with me are a lot of people. Should we start with Jaanam? Hey.
Hi Surbhi.
Hi Jaanam. Hey Abhishek.
Hi Surbhi.
Hi Navin.
Hi.
Hi Abbas.
Hi.
Hi Abhinav. I mean, he's a producer. He says hey. And there's Rahul also. So if you can do the math, there are a lot of people.
Yeah, which means a lot of stank in here.
Yeah.
So Surbhi, where have you been?
Oh, hey.
We haven't seen you in a while.
Man, I really miss being in the studio in spite of the number of people that they're here. But like, I definitely miss being in the studio with Abbas and John and my buddies. I've been away. I quit IVM because I had my own personal project to go to. But yeah, I really miss being in the studio and now I'm back to record a couple more episodes of Dating is Garbage. But if you like Dating is Garbage, you should check out my own podcast. I do a podcast now, Jaanam.
I know. I don't think our listeners do though.
Okay, it's called The Overthink Tank. It's where I overthink your problems. So, because I enjoy overthink so much. You can send me your problems and I will overthink it for you.
Let's overthink dating.
Oh man, let's do it. Dating is garbage. Today, our guest on the podcast is Naveen.
Yes.
And Abhishek.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
how the turntables.
Naveen is also a podcast host. Does everyone have a podcast in this room now?
More or less.
Four
out
of five.
Naveen has three podcasts.
OG, yeah.
We can't start plugging each one of them because that's half the episode.
Yeah, but then just like Google my name, you know.
Yeah.
It's just fine.
Hey, with Naveen we have Abhishek.
Hi.
Hey, Abhishek, do you want to explain how do you guys know each other?
We have been dating for 9 months.
Ooh.
What?
He's faster than any of us have been dating.
Yeah.
So, go you guys.
We've never had a couple.
We've never had a couple.
We've
the first couple on Dating is Garbage.
This is amazing.
It's going to be a disaster. The podcast, I mean.
But okay, on this episode, we're talking about green flags.
Okay.
Because like all this time, I know it's called Dating is Garbage and we shit on like everything dating related. But I thought it'll be nice to like talk about things that are green flags in a person and you go like, hey, this person might actually be nice, you know, and you see a future with them or like you kind of want to hang out more.
Yeah.
You see an immediate future with them.
Immediate future.
Maybe not a long-term commitment.
Of all the futures, this future makes sense. Like of all the timelines, I would choose this timeline.
Yeah.
Like, I'm going to be nerdy about that shit. Because I remember when I was back, not with Abhishek, I was like traveling with my show and, you know, doing all of that. So I was not planning on settling down per se. And I still had a terrible hangover from a relationship that happened like over a year ago, but I was still like, just like all over the place. And at that time, like around three people, like, you know, came and went through my life. Like pretty fast because you know I met them like second prospects maybe yes or no and then I got busy with shows and then it never happened and I was like I wonder why this never happened, maybe I'm the problem or whatever, until like he came along and then it happened, you know. So like I just feel like there's so many like strike one, strike two, strike three. It doesn't matter how many strikes you have, the important thing is like someday someone will just like
fit in
that adaptation will happen by default because your timelines will sync in a beautiful way.
Oh man, that's so nice.
These people, did you meet all of them organically or like?
More or less, yeah. Like some people like, so the thing by being like a queer comedian is that there's no other queer comedian so far. Like who's like prolific in the community and in the comedy scene. So there are a lot of people who see my shows and then approach me on Instagram or Facebook. So it's like kind of creepy sometimes. So I don't know whom to like cherry pick or whatever. But I'm like, okay, let's see if their profile is like no worthy.
How do you meet Abhishek?
Same.
Okay, let's ask Abhishek. Okay, so tell us what your first date was like and where did you guys meet?
And what was your first impression of Naveen?
Yeah.
Actually, being honest, my first impression of Naveen was 2 years ago. I was in Mumbai. I'm not from Mumbai. I am from Ahmedabad. And I was in Mumbai with my friends and I saw her show. At that time, I was dating someone else. I was like, chill, theek hai, doesn't matter anymore. And I like went back home. And then for some reason, I moved to Mumbai recently. like a year ago. And after that, that person broke up with me because I moved to Mumbai. And I'm like, cool. Then I suddenly, like, you know, I had this thing, like, I remember this guy. I went to his shows. Then I found him on Instagram. I texted him. And we kind of clicked. So we both have this thing. We like fat people. Like, you know, that's our type.
Yeah.
Chubby
yeah.
dudes.
Yeah, definitely.
So I texted him and we started talking. And our first, actually, conversation was started because of music. Okay. And, like, we have, like, very similar taste in music, which is, like, you know, very uncanny and very rare to find.
Yeah.
So because of that, we decided to meet. So our first date, what we decided, he had some other work, so he cancelled that.
Then Do you know who's influenced Naveen's taste in music the most?
This is like plug your own thing first.
He did show me your Spotify playlist.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
exactly.
Great, right?
Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah.
I just need
you
validation.
Have some, she has something called baby making music. And
oh, yeah. Do you all use it?
No, we can't make babies, but we
use it.
That makes me so happy.
I've used the baby making playlist. I would recommend it.
Yeah. I'm glad everyone else is using it, but me. But it's cool, yeah.
So the first night we met, we went out for coffee. And so,
ooh, do you want to name where this place is?
Oh, Starbucks. I have this thing. I'm like maybe a whore for Starbucks.
Nice.
I almost go there every day now.
What's anyway, your favorite drink to order there?
The matcha chai tea latte. I mean, the chai tea latte and the matcha latte.
Okay,
wow,
both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Mm.
matcha adu about latte.
Anyway, so after that, we went back to Akash's place, which is in Bandra, because he lives in Bhayandar, and that's like way too far away. Yeah. And I had like two roommates, so there's no way we can do it at my place.
Yeah.
So we,
that's true.
No. Yeah. Akash is in Akash Mehta.
Akash Mehta,
another host at
the IBM
Network.
Yeah, my co-host on Vartha Lab and also an official supporter of banking. So he's just like,
it's like,
yeah, whenever you want to chill, just get your own sheets. Is what he
says. BYO.
A nice little Vartha Lab fuck pad.
Okay, so you went to Akash's place.
Yeah, and it was pouring like crazy outside. So like,
wow,
we
so
could
romantic.
Not we could not do outside because it was like mad everything. I mean, we could not do outside as dating option. We could not do outsides. like the
outdoors.
Outside environment. Like, yeah, outdoors, I should have said. And we decided to like cozy up inside. And then I like being a romantic. Somebody at some event gave me free candles. Okay, so I got one candle to this date. And just like put it on the
desk.
You
just had the candle in your bag?
Yeah. I mean, like, for this day, I got it in my bag specially, okay?
Oh, wow.
I got it from
home.
You're
very romantic then?
Yeah, so nice. I just like, I lit the candle and then we just like played music, like, and this was like, okay, you play one song, I'll play one song, and let's see how it goes. And he's like, oh, you must have not heard about this. And I'm like, oh, I've heard about this. And he's like, okay, I'll show you one song you have not heard about. And like, oh, I've heard about this. Because and not only bullshitting, because we're singing the chorus parts together and all of that shit, okay? So it was kind of like in a dim light, and it was quite beautiful. And I had not planned to stay that whole night, because the reason I was going to Akash's was to catch a bus for Pune the next morning from Dadar. So Bandra's close by and whatever. But because it was raining, I'm like, okay, screw this, I'm gonna chill here. And we both like woke up at like 12 in the afternoon the next day, and I've not gone to Pune. It's still raining outside and we've not done anything. So we just like, you know, take one umbrella that I have, a very small one, and we go to American Express Bakery and get some like muffins and donuts, and that's a morning breakfast. And then we go back to watching like something. So we spend close to 23 hours together. That first date went on for like 23 hours.
You skipped your show?
No, my show was a week later. I was supposed to go to Pune earlier to do mics and, you know,
okay,
spend some time in the scene or whatever.
Okay.
But I cancelled everything. I just like was chilling here with this guy.
That's lucky. So nice. That's special.
But being honest, before meeting, we both had this thing in mind that we are not going to meet after this first date. Like, we did not talk about it, but I had this thing in my mind. I was talking to my friends and I was like, oh, I'm not going to meet this guy.
Oh,
it's just like
a
one-time thing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he had this thing in mind because he's like, oh, I'm very busy with my shows and thing. It's just like a one-time thing.
Yeah, and also I was traveling so much. I was going to go to, I was back from Bangalore then.
Yeah.
I was in Mumbai for a week when we met. Then I had to go to Pune, Kolkata, Goa, Chandigarh, Bangalore again. So I was like, okay, if I'm traveling so much, I'm gonna be, you know, an active participant in the culture of different cities.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was quite kind of terrible. And then like I went to Pune, and then immediately when the Pune show happened, I felt very ill. Like, I was with our friend Arshika,
right,
and I could not do anything over there for the entire week. I was there, I was bedridden, and only on the day of my show I gathered enough courage and, like, you know, warmth to stand up and go for the show. My friend Harshika, she drove me to the venue. And surprise, surprise, this one's taken a bus from Bombay and come to Pune to
so
see my show.
Nice. Yeah. Did he tell you, or it was a surprise?
Like, he told me. Like, no, nice. He was not planning to tell me until his bus crashed.
Oh yeah, that was
what?
Whoa.
There's
so much drama, guys.
The games, man, I'm telling you.
Wait, before we get into the crash, I wanna ask you, what made you go there? Like, you had just known him for like a day, right? Like, you all had just
I know.
Green flag.
And you knew the jokes already.
Yeah. No, actually his material changed a lot, so
he was there for the pigeon.
So you went for the jokes.
Yeah, so no, not for the jokes actually. So
came for the jokes, stayed for the body.
More like came for the body, stayed for the jokes.
Okay, sure.
No, but like it was something around August, and you know our college was having like a mini vacation of some sort. I don't know why, and going back home is like very far away. Like, even if I have to fly back home, that's like I don't want to go back home. So I decided to stay in Mumbai, but like again, I don't talk to a lot of people. I'm a very introverted person. I don't make friends. I have three friends, which includes him. So I'm like, what am I supposed to do? I'm like, I don't want to be here the entire day. I'm like, you know what, this guy's performing in Pune, and according to me, I have never been to Pune. I'm like, Pune is not that far. Everyone's like, it's so close to Mumbai. My best friend is from Pune, and she's like, oh, Pune is very close to Mumbai. I'm like, cool, it won't take me like more than 3 hours, I can go there. Turns out it took me fucking 6 hours to reach Pune. Six fucking hours. Okay. And I'm like, fine. And that's the reason. I was like, 3 hour drive and I can be with him, I can spend the night with him. I'm like, I can do that. And maybe the sex was very good, but
Maybe.
That's but, like one green flag.
Yeah. But what, the sex is very good?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's definitely. But taking from what you said about being an introvert, I feel like another green flag for me personally is, because I'm also like a little introvert, but if I'm hanging out with someone and it just feels like I'm alone, like it doesn't feel like I'm not putting so much energy into this, then it feels very comfortable.
You can just be.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. You have to just sit there.
A green flag,
You have to just sit there and do nothing.
Do nothing. Like, it just, things just happen.
Yeah, that person will do everything. That's the best thing.
Yeah, like someone else will do the entertaining for once.
But do you subscribe to this idea that you know within the first 15 to 20 minutes if there's going to be a second date?
No, not really.
Okay.
I think if we had just finished that date that night, we would have not probably met, like we had not planned to, you know. It was just like the situation was such that we wanted to see more of each other. But I personally felt it was after the first 20 hours at least. And it was not until we came back from Pune, by the way.
Yeah.
The way we came back from Pune was also like a nightmare. Because it was some holiday, some gudi padwa or some shit.
Yeah.
And like all the rickshaws, all the buses, everything was like gone, okay? Like nothing to come back from Pune to Bombay. And I had to be at Habitat back at 8 for an improv show. And around 2 I've left from Pune with no idea how to get back. And so now we're crammed in the back seat of a Toyota. Like
those shared cabs.
Yeah. So at the very back with like no leg space, and one Gujarati auntie like always annoyed for no reason. So, and we drove like that for like 4-5 hours, and like didn't take any stops. Our legs were just like gone. And I'm like, okay, if we can endure this together, I think we can endure much more in life. Like, it was horrifying. Like, we could not even turn the AC on without her complaining.
So the adversity got you all to like.
Yeah. And then like we made back to Dadar enough time to like go back to the show, do the show, and then like, you know, go back individually to our homes.
Oh man.
So that's how this all ended. So I'm like, okay, now we did all these things without like thinking about or planning, okay, we're going to do this. No, it just happened. And you know, like how it is, like in a journey-esque manner, like you're just like always there with that person, and they more or less add to what you're doing and make it smoother for you, for example. So that was like what kind of really stuck to us.
And one of the things, like, you know, during the first date, wherever we went and we spent money, every place, there was nothing like, oh, you have to pay entirely. We both were always like, you know, okay, we're going to go in half and half. So that one biggest factor in the gay community, which you find, is like, you know, most of the people are gold diggers.
Oh.
You can't like go anywhere without like having people wanting your money. That's a thing. Like,
I don't think any of us knew that.
We didn't.
The whole sugar daddy complex. Most of them are like that.
No, not
like,
most of them.
There's a
fair share of people who like just want to be like trophy wives, so to
say. Like the types of guys I like, they are always like that.
The types of, nice. This is a new fact for all of us.
Yeah,
that's nice. What other green flags did you have after this whole thing? Like when you start dating eventually, what were like some of your green flags? Like, hey, I think I should hang out with this person more.
like airports are sad, right? Like
what? Yeah, I airports. Love airports.
No, like when you leave and you come back, okay. Types, right? Like
yeah,
that
kind
of thing.
To someone.
And and he's always like, so since I was like traveling to like five different cities, every time I came back, he was there. Like by default, he was at the airport.
Do you do a dramatic
there's a Starbucks at the airport.
Alright, we get it. It's a Starbucks, not you.
But there is also Starbucks at other places.
But like, you know, he's coming and there's a Starbucks as well. Like,
okay, so like
Two in one.
Man, I'm
so I think the biggest green flag for you is a Starbucks.
Yeah,
yeah.
Which is,
it's literally
has a green,
green.
Logo.
It has a green logo. Yeah. It
no,
is a green
I think,
logo.
I think one of the main reasons also, like, for example, after my show, we didn't get time to date properly also. Like, we don't do couple things. We don't, like, go to a dinner and then, like, have a theater plan or whatever. I'm performing every evening, literally. Like, I'm doing stage time. He'll come and watch the show sometime. Like,
oh, yeah, I see his stories. He's always putting up stories.
He's watched
you.
All the comics in the scene right now. All the comics know about him. And, like, he's only second to Ronak Rajani's girlfriend, by the way. Henna, who's also, like, always there at every show with Ronak. But, So that's what, you know. And if I went back to Bayandar after the show, like, he would come with me in the train all the way and then probably take an Uber back home. Like,
what?
You know,
you're so dedicated to this whole thing. That's amazing.
Yeah, like, he put in more effort than I did, I'll be honest about that. Because
but that's okay.
That's the thing, my lifestyle as a comic does not allow me to, like, have a steady relationship also. So the fact that he went out of his way to, like, make everything work out, and then, like, now we have reached the rhythm where we both, like, have sync with each other, and I'm freelancing, so I can spend a day with him sometimes, and in the evening I can do my shit and come back to him in the night, and then he does his college work and everything, and then he's also free in the evening, so we have our own rapport now. We have kind of had a schedule syncing, like, a period, but it's nice.
And now you're getting a flat together.
Yeah, we're moving in together.
Wow.
Officially.
And you have a cat together.
We have a cat
together. The cat
that's
called
an interesting story.
Okay.
The cat's called, so basically the cat ka pura naam, it's so we are like one of the very first things, like, other than music, was like drag queens, like RuPaul's Drag Race, the show.
Oh man, I remember those days when all Navin used to do in office was watch.
That is like me. So we were like huge fanatics. Okay,
my y'all are like, I see now why y'all are. Yeah,
So we had that as well.
Like, if you're not talking like this, we're talking in drag lingo. We're like, yes, girl, go, oh my god,
So, like, I think a week after us meeting for the first time, I found this cat near my house in a dumpster. And I'm like, you know what? I can't do. So, before I moved to Mumbai, I moved to Mumbai because my older cat died. And I wanted to, like, get away from that city, kind of like a thing. Like, you know, and, like, I'm done with the city. My cat died here. I don't want to live here anymore. So a week later, after I met Navin, I found a cat in a dumpster. And I'm like, you know what? Fuck this. I'm taking this cat home. Till date, my landlord hates my cat. I have to hide him whenever my landlord comes over.
This podcast should not reach his ears.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
Yeah, I'm moving anyway.
No, actually, it should. We should tell him cats are harmless.
I know, right?
They don't bark. They don't bite.
Exactly.
They're clean.
They're
clean. And my cat's like the most laziest
Your
piece
cat's
of...
Your cat is beautiful. We need to post that
Thank
photo.
You.
Yes.
Everywhere.
Our cat is a passive stoner, actually. That's what he is. He's a chiller who just, like, give me food and let me sleep. I'm happy.
You guys are giving, like, a new meaning to the green light.
That's a green flag. If someone does not like to smoke up, I'm not dating them. Hands down. Okay. That's a big green flag.
Yeah. No, that's right. The opposite for me. If someone is, I'm
okay.
It's kind of a red flag for me.
What's a green flag for you, Jaanam?
Man, I
it could be something basic. I mean, it doesn't have to be like traveling to Pune for you, but it could be something basic.
Okay, by the way, done that also.
Wow.
Exhausting as hell. But green flag for me, you know what? Interestingly, I recently went on a really good date. And we were having a great conversation. There was chemistry. But we even kind of spoke about a second date. But I'm not... The thing is, right now in my life, I'm not looking for anything.
Okay,
like, I'm very.
We're looking at the positives here. So tell us what.
When it comes to green flags, Jaanam is colorblind, right?
Yeah, that's
what I am actually. I'm just so focused on, like, just myself right now and giving that attention to myself that even.
Okay, so what was the thing
for.
That made you think of a second date with this guy?
Yeah. One was, like, we were having a really good conversation.
What made the conversation great? Let's get into the details.
What is a conversation?
We spoke about a lot of, like, heavy stuff. A lot of, like, family.
Is this a therapy session?
It was kind of. It was maybe a therapy session. But what made the conversation great was just interest in similar things. That's like pretty basic. That was there. I don't know. It was just like two people talking and not being judged by one another, which I've experienced after a long time.
Yeah, that's very nice. But I'm assuming it's a green flag for everybody in the room, where like someone's actually listening to you and they're not like just waiting for their turn to talk. Yeah. Like, oh, you finished, but I have a better story to tell. What were you, Abbas?
You feel comfortable in that person's presence. Mm-hmm. You share jokes.
Abbas, you can't drop jokes in a date. That's how your audience. I mean, you can, but you can't expect them to like laugh at all jokes.
Yeah, like if you're a poet, it's a different thing altogether. Yeah. Because then you can masquerade your poem as your thing.
As real emotion.
Yeah, yeah. But you're like, let me open this sheet. Hey, what about air hostesses?
Here's the thing about air hostesses.
Yeah, and praise that she's an air hostess for that joke to work.
No, but a good sense of humor is a big green flag.
That's true.
Oh, yeah. So like, basically like, even that is what like connects us. Like, we love dead baby jokes and like something that's really like wild. And
dark
like,
humor, basically. Dark humor.
Yeah. So, I mean, I get the whole dark humor thing, but when you say a good sense of humor, what if their sense of humor is very different from yours? Like, I know this person who cracks really lame jokes, okay?
Right.
Like, it's a different kind of humor, but I don't get it.
Okay,
so
then,
I don't get it.
Then it's not agree. Then it's a red flag if you don't like that humor.
I won't say it's a red flag, but then you don't get that kind of humor, which is fine.
That's true.
Yeah.
So it doesn't have to be this.
Oh God, this is so relatable. I know a person who was super nice, who ticked all the boxes, but just the kind of humor he was into, I was like, I can't.
Tarak Mehta.
No, it wasn't Tarak Mehta. He was just so like debating.
Achha.
Like every time he'd have to say like a joke, he'd start with like a, oh no, what I think is.
Yes.
I'm like, it's not sexy.
Jokesplaining.
Yeah, it was very like, fuck. Oh yeah, so that was messed up.
One weird red flag that I have is like, if someone, I'm going on a date with them, and then post date we're chilling, and we do our cuddly stuff, and then if they would use the bathroom afterwards, if they lock the door, I'm like, okay, I don't trust them.
We don't lock the door.
I'm like, we just banged uglies right now, right? So like, what are you doing inside? I can't like guess already.
That person is shitting inside.
There's two people in the entire room. Like one of them goes in the bathroom, the other knows, right? Like just don't open the door. That's like how.
But what if the other person
is creepy and into something which the other person is not?
Maybe it's not exactly
so, like,
creepy.
On our first date, we didn't like lock the doors both of times.
But we closed the door. We did not lock them, but we
closed the door. We closed the door. I'm not saying open and shut. I'm just saying this, don't latch, because then it feels like, okay, you don't trust me enough to like.
Achha, I got
okay.
it.
I
so for you, that door is
a barrier.
Like
a barrier
enough. Yeah. Mm.
That's why I said it's weird.
It's, okay, so green flag for you is a person who's shitting without the door locked, allowed the latch.
Yeah, like close the door, let the smell inside, but like.
Yes, this is getting
super. But just like, don't lock it to be like, oh, this person's gonna come inside and slap me while I'm pooping.
No. Just come inside, that's enough.
Oh, yeah. There's been some escalation for that. Like, I just like came inside, looked at it, and went back.
Okay, guys, this is getting super interesting. Let's take a quick break and we'll be right back on Dating is Garbage.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure that you do. We're IVM Podcast on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Please, please do. With the upcoming election season just around the corner, in case you really wanted a deep dive into some of the issues that matter, you should check out some of the shows on our network. Shows like Ganatantra, The Seen and the Unseen, The Pragati Podcast, Pulia Bazi, and even How to Citizen look into some of the issues that really do matter. This week on Cyrus Says, Cyrus is joined by Tripti Khamkar. Tripti talks about how she got into acting from a young age, convincing her family, discovering her comedic talent, and her very own podcast, Gol Gappa. On Shunya One, Varun Deshpande from the Good Food Institute joins us to talk about the Good Food Institute and the work that they're doing. On Thalle Harate, our Kannada podcast, Pawan and Surya discuss the Indian judiciary and all that we need to know about its citizens. On Paisa Vaisa, Anupam hosts an hour-long special with Anil Gilani, head of passive investments at DSP Mutual Fund, and Mukesh Agarwal, CEO of NSE Indices, India's largest index and index service provider. This week, look out for the 50th episode of the Habit Coach podcast. Host Ashton Doctor is joined by a special guest on this one. And with that, let's continue with your show.
Hey guys, welcome back to Dating is Garbage. We are here with Navin, Abhishek, and Abbas and Surbhi.
And a lot of people.
Five. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I did too.
Yeah.
How amazing was Hampach?
It was great.
Speaking of green flags, is this a thing with you guys if you're into like dogs or cats, and if the opposite person, like, I mean, it's pretty obvious, yeah? Like, isn't it?
Animals in general.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, actually for me, you're right.
Yeah.
Not just cats, but the other person has to be an animal lover.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, just be kind to animals in general.
Yeah.
Like on our first date, I remember he picked me up from the station in a cab, and we had to pick the keys up from a friend near Bandra. And I went to pick the keys. So meanwhile, he's given the cab guy more money than he should have given, because he's a nice person that day. And, like, he always treated people nicely, like the staff and everybody waiting.
Yeah.
Right. I'm not that person. So
yeah,
he's
nice.
That. Sorry?
I tip everyone.
He tips everyone. And,
hey, green flag.
And so we get out of the car and, like, I go to get the keys and this guy found a dog and, like, now he's cuddling him on the pavement. He's just like,
aww.
On the, I have photo proof.
That's it's a major not, green flag.
Yeah, he's just like, he's playing with the dogs in the mud now. Like, that's how he's become.
I think Abhishek is a walking green flag.
Yeah. So I was like, okay, I love dogs. He's amazing. And then, like, after that, we got the cat and he told you the whole story about the cat. And I was not, like, really into cats before that.
Ah.
But this one won my heart over.
Man, that's
so
nice.
What you were saying about your cat, right?
Oh,
what?
So yeah, after I found him in a dumpster, I brought him home. And I asked my roommates, I was like, hey, do you guys love cats? So one of my roommates is like, you know, a very vile straight person. And he's like, yeah, I love pussies.
Oh, shit.
Wild straight wild, people.
That's a classic straight man thing to say.
I love pussies. These wild people.
No, but like, he's my best friend. He's like an amazing person. But he's like, oh yeah, yeah, I love pussies, I want a cat. I'm like, cool.
Yeah, that's a straight person.
Yeah. That was his explanation why he wants a cat, because he loves pussy.
Yeah, for me it made sense because I had left for Kolkata back then, so like he had to fill some void. So
oh,
he
please.
Got
you didn't really leave that much void. But yeah, anyway, I got that cat and, you know, I was like very attached to him. I'm like, what should I name him? So I used to do poetry pehle and I'm like, oh yeah, I can name him Quill because, like, you know, that feather pen thingy. So I named him Quill. He comes back from Kolkata, Bangalore, Goa, everything. He does everything. And then he is here and it's been like 4 months since we are dating. And we are like, oh, Quill is kind of like an odd name. I mean, we love Quill, but, like, you know, what? So we are planning to get his papers, like a proper adoption paper. So whenever we travel, we can have him with us.
What is adoption?
adoption papers.
I think combine adaptation and
adoption.
Yeah, so...
So you actually have adoption papers for your cat?
Yeah,
we're getting them.
Oh, that's my birthday gift.
Yeah, it's like we have to get them vaccinated.
Nice. So when's your birthday?
26th March.
Oh,
ooh, one day before mine.
Nice plug.
Oh, my legal birthday is 27th March.
Really?
Yeah.
What? Oh, so you have a legal birthday?
So, like, my dad kind of fucked this up. I was born on 26th March, raat mein 12 o'clock.
Wow. Oh, you're a midnight child.
Yeah, so I have that thing. Like, legally, I have to be 27. Mm. But 26.
I don't know why I blame my dad. You can celebrate both days, yeah?
I do. I get gifts both days.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, going back to the cat. So
yeah, so, you know, he came back home and he's like, oh, Quill is like a good name, but like it should be something like, you know, more powerful. I'm like,
more
okay.
Powerful.
And he just goes like, how about Lord Quillington Thunderfuck 5000?
Oh my god.
Oh wait, that's a reference from something. Drag
yeah,
Queen.
Drag Queen.
Yeah, Alaska Thunderfuck 5000.
Oh my god,
queen.
I know this.
That's my favorite drag queen. I'm like, yeah, totally down for that.
So he has a drag queen surname and a Lord's first name. So it's like...
And... After a month, he's like, oh, this name is like, we should name him Billy Eilish. So, like, now his name
so
is Billy Eilish.
He's coming up with puns only.
Yeah,
and then
yeah.
You keep
so, that's name. Also a green flag, like the person being punny.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that definitely being into puns is great. Abbas, you think something?
Yeah, I love puns. But there
puns
are people
are
for that for whom that is a red flag, actually.
Really?
Yeah, because they consider it as the lowest form of humor.
Oh, man, come on.
Yeah,
I
don't
think I care about people.
No,
the only ones who don't like puns are the ones who don't get it.
That's
all.
Yeah.
If you don't get
or
puns,
people
you're
don't enjoy the little things of life. You
yeah.
know, I don't want that person, man.
Also,
life.
it takes effort to come up with puns. Yeah, it's not
oh,
easy.
Oh man.
Yeah.
Look at us. We come up with episode name titles and everything has. If it has a pun, it has more clicks, right? I mean,
yeah. It's like a clickbait thing.
But we love puns.
And clickbaits.
And, yeah, both.
And animals.
And animals. Abbas, what are some of your green flags? Because you mentioned two red flags for now. Like,
no, I mentioned sense of humor.
You mentioned
green
sense
flag.
Of humor. Yeah.
Mm, what else?
Abbas likes only one green flag. Am I right? Sorry.
Two comedians making risky humor. But let me ask Naveen this. How much of a, like, if they are into the same pop culture as you, if they are not. So I'm beginning to kind of let that go a little bit.
Oh,
like,
I have a lot
someone,
to say about that. I have a lot to say about that, okay? There are certain things that he's not watched, which I'm really like, he should watch them more often. And like, that 70s show, he's not watched.
Okay.
But at the same time, he's watched like What is that other Mexican show you keep watching?
One Day at a Time.
I haven't watched that.
That's a good show.
Like, he likes two broke girls. I like more Modern Family. So, like, we have different tastes, but like, somewhere we merge together and come together. Thing is, he's made an effort towards Star Wars. That's one effort he generally made.
That's huge.
But I might add, he fucks up the references all the time.
It's a big universe to get into, I guess.
He thinks Luke is Han Solo all the time, which is just like a sin.
I can't believe this. This is so... Watching the whole Star Wars is a big deal. I will never do it.
It's actually interesting, I'll say. And I watched Star Wars many years back, not even under the influence
of
any guy.
Have you done it for a boy?
No, I did not.
Doing it for someone, like being in a relationship, is a huge deal. And I applaud this man, Abhishek.
That was forced on me.
I know. Are you going to make him watch Lord of the Rings?
Oh, that's a plan. That's a plan.
Not doing that.
It's on my list.
We've been avoiding it for a while.
What next? He's going to make you watch Die Hard.
No, I don't care about Die Hard.
Please.
That again, like, he's more into rom coms. I'm into action.
Oh, I force him to watch rom coms.
Oh, that's good. But nobody needs to be. You need to be forced to watch rom coms.
As in, like,
he does.
We have to do this whole, like, okay, one night you pick the movie, one night I pick the movie. And thing is, like, we pick a movie. We picked Orphan the other day. Like, we were like, okay, let's watch a horror movie. And then I slept. So he finished the movie.
Right.
I know I haven't watched the movie. So I'm like, okay, I want to watch the movie, but I can't watch without him. So, like, now I'll never watch Orphan.
And now you have to. He has to watch it twice.
I can rewatch. Oh, yeah. I love the movie.
That's what he says now.
This is a lot.
Like, here's the thing. So one of my biggest green
flags.
You open
the jukebox now, basically. That's what it is right now. It's like, just like, I keep spilling more secrets.
Yeah, let me talk now. One of the biggest green flags for me is like loving rom-coms. Okay. I keep on randomly asking him names of rom-coms. Like, oh, do you know who's the actress in Made in Manhattan? Then I'll just, like, you know, be like, I'll give him a dialogue randomly. I'll be like, I'm just a girl standing in front of a guy wanting him to love me. I'm like, do you know which movie is this from?
Oh, man.
And he's like, if he doesn't know the answers, I'm ready to throw a fit. I mean, how do you not know this?
Everything so is Bridget Jones' Diary.
No.
No.
Or Notting Hill.
Yeah, no, it's Notting Hill. It's in Notting Hill.
That's the rom-com knowledge you have. But that's amazing. I think another green flag for me is when you're talking to someone and it's just like they're actually listening to you.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I've said this before.
But that was the first time.
I was just checking.
But all the relationship.
And also, like, you know, that person loving your style, no matter it's like fashion or anything. For me, that has been the thing since like childhood. I have had the weirdest style. Like, I either wear like totally psychedelic looking clothes or like I'm like in all black.
I only have those two things, super fucking colorful or
completely black. And like my hair is like, since I think past 4 years, I have not seen my actual hair color. I just keep on changing it and changing it. And tattoos. And I can't be with a person
who's
like...
How many tattoos do you have? You seem to have like a lot.
Yeah, I have like 5 right
now. Wow.
Visible 5. Yeah.
Do you have each other's name tattooed?
Come
on.
But he's getting a silhouette of our photo together.
Yeah.
Wow.
Which I'm very much against, but still.
What's a silhouette? So mean.
Yeah.
I mean, like,
if you find somebody like me.
Yeah, exactly.
No. My whole idea is, if we have a breakup, I'll turn his face into the devil's face. That's why I'm not having his eyes and everything.
That's a good plan.
Yeah.
That's really.
And they're both like fat guys, so they are going to date fat guys.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You'll find someone.
There's no possibility.
I'm kind of rooting for you guys, though, in a way.
I forgot to mention another thing that's really nice. You know, when a guy, like whoever your romantic interest is, they really like remember tiny things about you. So like, say if I'm mentioning, oh, I really like this jacket, and like out of the blue they gift me that jacket, I'm like,
that is me.
I know, I can tell. Abhishek here is a giant green flag. I'm sorry. It's great. But has it happened to you, Abbas? Have you ever like gone out of the blue and just like gifted someone something because you really like them?
Comics are broke, right?
So yeah.
Have someone done this to you?
Yeah, someone has done that for me.
Do you want to give us the details?
No, it was a book I mentioned, and they ordered an international edition because it wasn't available on the Indian Amazon.
That's so nice.
Where do you find these people?
I might just like be a little gloaty right
not
now.
Not Tinder.
That's true.
Not Tinder. But like, I've had a history of very like giving people in my life. Like, when I've dated people. Like one guy from Chennai, I remember that was like 5 years ago. I was still in college. And I just spoke to him for 45 minutes. That's all I did. Like nobody in the gay community was ready to speak to him. I was the only one from Bombay speaking to him in Chennai. And like he fell in love with me over the call, okay? So now he's sending me gifts. Like I just mentioned I like James Corden. So he sends me a DVD of History Boys, which is a James Corden movie.
Oh, shit, so cute.
Okay, and I'm like, okay, now Life of Pi is coming out, the movie. I'm so excited. He sends me the book, Life of Pi, okay? So I'm just like, why is this guy giving me so many things? I'm not even like asking any of this. And then he came to Bombay to meet me. Like there was a friend's wedding that he was under the guise of basically coming. But he was there to meet me. And I went and broke his heart by like saying that I'm not looking for this. And I had to see like a grown ass man wailing like in front of me, and I could not do anything because I was never like, okay, I was like, okay, I'll give your things back if that's what you like.
No, that's not what that would hurt him even more.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, so, but okay, were you not in a space to invest in that relationship?
No, I was not. I was not into him at all.
Oh, okay.
I made just, it very clear. Like,
you were just
like,
being friendly and he took it the wrong way.
Was he not like, chubby?
He was massively chubby.
Okay.
I don't know, okay. Like probably too chubby.
See, you're not into him. That's okay.
Yeah, yeah.
That's,
but the thing is, like, I felt shitty after that. I didn't like. I don't want to lead anybody on since then. So I'm like, okay, I want to keep my reality up front. You know what I'm going to do.
That's a good point. Another thing that I feel like it's a good red flag is I'm so used to saying red flag. But okay, there's something I do. I know maybe it's a nice thing, but like I remember like tiny details of a person and then I bring it up in conversations like, oh, remember when that happened? And that person's so shocked that I remember these tiny details. Like I remember their lucky number and they're like, how do you remember that?
You just green flagged yourself though.
Yeah, I'm like, I was that. I have some green flag things. Is that a green flag for you guys when like someone remembers like details like, oh, you know when that happened and they keep...
Definitely. It is?
Yes, but not to an obsessive extent.
Yeah, listen. You're breaking my heart right now.
I mean, I've had people who have remembered like tiny details and at first it feels very like, oh wow, they remember. But yeah. Then I have been led on and like fucked over. So
it's... Oh, you're just like...
I mean, that is...
You don't want to get played.
Yeah. So now if somebody actually remembers details... I'm like, okay, what else? What more? Like,
yeah.
Because that's not enough.
Ah.
Yeah.
So what is a good, like a major green flag for you? Like that will change the game and that will make that person a second date worthy for you.
Honestly, right now, nothing.
Okay, not right now. In an ideal situation, everyone knows that Jaanam is avoiding going on any dates whatsoever.
Yeah. What is a green flag?
In the bigger picture, it could be... I don't know, being a Brad Pitt.
Honestly, they would have to really, really...
Wow, even Brad Pitt is not cutting it. Yeah.
Beg, like bow down.
Wow. Yeah.
Okay.
Somebody would have to really go to like, get the moon for me, man. Fucking, I'm not going to be impressed by anything else.
Thanos, put on a pedestal.
Yeah, damn it, I haven't been.
Yeah, that's true. I think Jaanam needs to be on the other side of the relationship when she's the one on the pedestal, not the guy.
Exactly.
I think I appreciate
it.
I
think I've done enough. I've always been the one giving, so like now it's my turn to.
Yeah.
Nice.
Which is the thing, because I feel like another thing that I've noticed in my, like, the pattern that I have in a relationship is I keep giving. And then I keep going, like, why do I not get anything in return?
Yeah.
But that's the point. Because if you leave no room for the other person to give, they won't. They'll be like, oh, this person is okay with giving me as much. So I can take a step back, which is the thing I learned. Now you should do a 50-50 thing.
Yeah.
Or like be on equal footing. Abhishek, you were saying something.
More like miming.
Gesturing something.
Yeah. I was like, that was me in the beginning of the relationship. So like, we started dating in August. Mm. And like, you know, a week later, it was his birthday.
Mm.
So I'm like,
such a good time.
Yeah, no, it was not. I was like, should I give him something? Will this work out? Am I supposed to buy something expensive? Because if I'm giving him something, I can't give him like something cheap, right?
Mm. Okay, then what do you end up giving him?
I gave him a jacket. My brother lives in America, so he got it for me. So
what? You went?
Was this the Pharrell Williams?
No, that's the
other
boyfriend.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't mention I have a history of being people in my life.
That's the other boyfriend. Oh my god, I'm sorry for bringing your ex.
This one was the Drake jacket.
Wait, but you went all the way. You asked your brother to get you a jacket.
Oh yeah. So like after our first date, the first thing I did is like, so my brother's like my best friend. So I told him ke, hey, this is the guy I went out on a date with him. And he's like, okay, cool. Then like, you know, I just keep him there. Like, you know, he knows what I'm doing in my life. So yeah, So I was like, hey, it's his birthday. He's like, fine, I'll send you something. Then he sent me a jacket. But the best part is the jacket arrived a month later because it got stuck in customs.
Yeah.
So I'm like, if this thing works out for an entire month, I will give it to him. Varna,
hey,
I can wear.
Yeah,
because like, we are the same size.
We're the same size.
This is convenient. I think that's a good thing.
Oh, that's a green flag.
Man, that's real. That really is.
The major green flag for at least two fat gays is that.
Yeah.
And that's what I think our show should be called, Two Fat Gays. Two broke girls. But like, we just like wear each other's clothes all the time. Just like whatever
fits. Doing that,
man,
like,
yeah. This could be great. Just like having clothes.
Find someone your size.
Find someone your size.
Or like maybe bigger than you. Because like, you know that boyfriend shirt feel. I don't get that.
Oh
man.
Or just like stop growing fat.
But that's great. I feel like Abhishek, we have a lot of respect for you.
You're
great.
This has been the most positive episode of Dating is Garbage, where two people really like each other.
I think this episode is called Dating is Not That Garbage also. It's like fine only.
Dating is garbage.
Thanks, Naveen. Thanks, Abhishek, for being on this podcast. Where can we reach out to you on your social media?
I'm House of Noronha.
Abhisuko. Everywhere.
Say it again.
Abhisuko. Abhisuko.
Nice.
That's the spelling?
Yeah.
What's
spelling.
The Suko reference?
Oh, so my old Instagram, it used to be Suck My Boohoo. Like,
I'm glad I asked.
This is another episode.
S-U-C-C, Suck My Boohoo. And Aditi Mittal, she, for some reason, she read it and she said, oh, Suko. And she started calling me Suko. And then everybody started calling me Suko. So currently, my name is Suko.
Yeah.
Oh.
His personality just like, it screams Suko. So
do you go to Suko Thai?
I have a massage.
You have
Bye.
A massage.
You can reach out to us on IVM Podcasts. We are at IVM Podcasts on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And you can also reach out to the hosts individually. Abbas, where can one find you?
You can reach out to me on Twitter at Abbas Momin.
Surbhi, you can reach out to me on Twitter at SmallTalkPolice. And don't forget to listen to The Overthink Tank. It's available in all podcasting apps.
And you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Jaanam Divan. See you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Mm. Bye.
Why can't we see we've built these things up in our head? Who we think is the one always ends up with someone else. Dating is garbage, I'm not sure why people do it. It's a pain in the ass, nothing but trouble, a giant fucking nuisance. Maybe it's better than being lonely.
Hi, my name is Anupam Gupta, I'm B50 on Twitter. I am the host of Paisa Paisa, the show that talks money. On my show, I speak to experts from every field of money and finance, from stock markets, equities, debt funds, credit cards, life insurance, every possible area of money and finance that you can think of. We even did an episode on cryptocurrency. I've got fantastic guests from mutual funds to personal finance experts everywhere, robo-advisory, startups, just name it, we've got it. At Paisa Paisa, we help you make smart decisions about money. You work hard for money. Now make your money work hard for you. New episodes out every Monday, and you can listen to my show on the IVM Podcast app or any other podcasting app that you have. Paisa Paisa is brought to you by Paytm Money.
How aware do you think you are of your laws and rights? Do you look up to laws when you are caught up in situations? Do you know what your rights are when you're stuck somewhere bad? Well, here's a show that can help you move an inch closer to being aware of what your rights are. Tune into Know Your Kanoon with me, Amber Rana. This is a podcast meant to answer all your law-related queries. Catch Know Your Kanoon every week on the IVM website or the app or anywhere you get your podcast from.